In this video, I will show an example of so-called supernormal growth dividend. Supernormal growth dividend is the pattern of future dividends that we assume we know that has two growth stages. For the first few years, the dividends will be grown at a very high or supernormal growth rate every year. And after that, the growth rate will slow down to some lower percentage increase every year in perpetuity. So in something complicated like this, how would we find how much one share of stock is worth today, which is essentially the price per share? How much should a share cost? So let's look at the following example. Let's say we are given the following. We have this timeline, right? Timeline. And let's mark a few years. So year zero, year one, year two, three, four, five, and so on. So year zero is essentially today, right? And this is the year for which we need to find the price, right? So what is the price? Then let's say we are also given the first dividend amount in 1 year. It's $4 dividend per share, right? And then what we also know is that for the first 3 years, let me do it like this. The growth rate will be, so the growth rate is, let's make it 50% per year. After that, the growth rate will change to 20% per year. So 20% per year. Okay, so this is the rate at which the dividend amount will be increasing every year. Okay, and then one more number that we should know is, let's put it right here, R. R equals, let's make it 25%. So this is the annual rate of return, which is also the same thing as the discount rate in this problem. The rate at which you will be discounting each future dividend to bring them all to year zero, which is today, which then gives us the value of one share of stock. Okay, so here's how I would recommend solving this problem. In my opinion, this is by far the easiest solution. First, I want you to calculate one by one the dividends for the first few years, and you stop at the end of the first growth stage. So dividend in year two and dividend in year three. So what is the dividend that the company will pay to each stockholder after 2 years? So we can do $4, right? $4 multiplied by 1 plus 0.5, right? Which gives $6. So we put $6 here. And of course, this can also be done in the financial calculator. Let's turn it on. Let's make sure nothing is stored from any early calculations. Reset, second, plus minus, enter. Off and on again. How would you find $6 after 2 years? So we are starting with $4. That's our present value. Four, make it negative by pressing the plus minus button, and then press PV, which stands for present value. 1 year later, after growing by 50%, what will the dividend be equal to? So 1 year is 1N. At 50% growth, that's our rate of growth, so 50 IY button, and we need to find essentially the value after 1 year, which is the future value. So I press compute FE, $6. Okay, so $6 is correct. Now the same way, either using the formula by hand or using the financial calculator, you can calculate the next dividend. And this is the last one that you will need to calculate, even though the dividends will keep growing in perpetuity, but you don't need the rest. So what is going to be the next one? So we have, so you can do $6 times 1 plus 0.5 again, which will equal $9. So this is 9. Or you can also do the original $4 times 1 plus the 50% growth, or 0.5 in decimals, to the second power, which equals $9. Or you can again use the financial calculator. So let's turn it on. Again, let me use $4 as my present value. 4, make it negative, PV. 2 is my new N, number of years. 50 is still the same growth rate. That's for year 1 and year 2. Sorry, year 2 and year 3, right? 50 is my IY, compute future value, $9. Okay, so this is correct. This is step 1, essentially, right? So this is my step 1. What do I do next? $9 in 3 years is the last dividend for the first growth stage. But it's also the first dividend in the second growth stage, where the dividends would be growing at 20% per year in perpetuity, right? So let me, circle all these dividends, starting here, 3 dividend, $9. And this is what we call a growing perpetuity, right? Growing perpetuity. Okay, so if we use the formula for the present value of this growing perpetuity, right? The formula says what? PV of a growing perpetuity equals, we take the cash flow amount and divide by R minus G, right? So cash flow amount is basically the very first dividend in this endless growing perpetuity, right? So this is the very first dividend in the growing perpetuity. Perpetuity. And so what I'm doing is, I'm putting $9 in the numerator, right? $9. And I divide it by R minus G. What is R? R is given. That's the annual rate of return. So this is basically how profitable the company is that's paying you the dividends. Every year, it's making a 25% return every single year. So that's our R. In decimals, that's 0.25. And it's important what we use for G. It's the growth rate. So which growth rate is it? Is it the 50% growth rate, which is for the first 3 years, or the 20% growth rate, which is from that point on? It's the 20% growth rate. So I subtract 0.20. And the number I get is $180, right? Because it's essentially, I take 9 and divide it by 0.05, right? 0.05 is 0.25 minus 0.2 equals $180, okay? But the important thing, let me again change the color and explain something. So this is not our answer yet. This is not how much each share should cost today. Instead, the way this present value of a growing perpetuity formula is built, It gives the present value of, endlessly growing dividends one time period before the very first one. So the very first one was $9, right? That's 3 years from today. We need to go back by 1 year. And so $180 is in year two, right? It's 2 years from today. That's important. So essentially, 180 can be put here under year two. Now, let me change the color again to black and do the following. So let's simplify everything that's going on to the following. So it's as if we have the following. We have year 0, year 1, year 2, year 3. Let's put dot, dot, dot after year 3. It's as if we have $4 at the end of the first year. Then we have $6 at the end of the second year. And we also have $180 at the end of the second year. So 180, which can be added up to $186 total. And we have nothing after that year. So nothing at all in perpetuity. So there are only essentially two numbers that we are left with. $4 in 1 year and $186 in 2 years. And now we need to use the 25% discount rate, which is given, to find the combined present value of these two future cash flows. And that will be the answer to our problem. So how do we do that? We use a financial calculator, so-called cash flow keys, right? Cash flow keys. So let's clear the calculator. Second, plus, minus, enter. How do the cash flow keys work? You press the cash flow button in the second row. It asks you for cash flow in year zero. The default is $0, and we want to leave it this way because when you would be buying this share of stock, you wouldn't receive any dividend right away. So year zero is blank. We want to save it as $0. Press enter, then the down arrow key. Cashflow 01, cashflow number one in the future, that's what it means. What's the first cashflow in the future? That's a 4-year dividend that will be paid in 1 year, which was already given to us. So you press 4, enter, you have just saved it. Press the down arrow key. What is F01? F stands for frequency, which means how many times in a row do we have $4 on our timeline? It's only once, which is pretty much always the case in most problems. So you press enter down, or you can also press just down, the down arrow key, and it will work. Cashflow 02, what's the second cashflow in the future? That's $186, right? Which is a combination of the $6 dividend that we calculated first and $180, which is basically all the dividends after the second year, all of them in perpetuity, the entire perpetuity of growing dividends summarized in this one number. So they're all evaluated in end of year $2. So 180 replaces everything after the second year, right? And so 186 is our cash flow number two in the future. So I press 186, enter, down arrow key. What's the frequency of it? It's only once, so I keep it at one and I press the down arrow key. Or I could press enter and then the down arrow key. It wouldn't make any difference. What's my cash flow 03? So that's the third cash flow in the future. We don't have any more. It's all blank. We have simplified what was given to us with just two numbers on our timeline, 4 and 186. So we are done with entering the cash flows. Now we press the NPV button, which stands for net present value. The display wants us to enter the information about the discount rate, which is the capital I. That's 25%, which is given. So I press 25, enter, down, and compute. $122.24. This is my answer. So my answer is $122.24. Right? So to summarize, I solved this problem in how many steps? Kind of in three steps. Or actually, okay, let me show in more detail. So we did the $6 dividend, that was step one. Then the $9 dividend, that was step two. Then we found $180, that was step three. The discounted sum of all dividends starting year three, evaluated in year $2. And then we combined the second year dividend with 180, so we can say that this is our step four, and then step five is the cash flow case, right? Let me just highlight them. And this is how you solve, you know, supernormal growth dividend problems. And just very quickly, my other video, which solves the same exact problem and gets the same answer, has an extra step in which I find the dividend at the end of the fourth year. But this video right here does not use that step at all. So it's much faster, and this makes it a lot easier.